I'm your host, Dr. Carol Swain. I am here to speak truth to power. Like you, I'm concerned about the direction of our country and the future in store for our children and grandchildren. This show will serve as a voice for conservative Americans and a call to action for the we the people mentioned in the preamble of the Constitution. James and I have been friends for several years. We became closer friends after I was attacked by the Southern Poverty Law Center. That's that dastardly group in Montgomery, Alabama, that now maligns conservatives.
We got to know each other as a result of a column I had written in which I saw a quote of yours in the Washington Post, and I made some snarky comment about it. You emailed me and said my comment was unfair. I said, okay, respond. So you wrote a response, I put it in my column, and I was convinced that I had been unfair.
Could you talk a little bit about how one becomes a political journalist and the pros, the cons, any tips you can give them?
So I have three pieces of advice to people who are thinking about a career in political journalism. One is make sure it's what you really want to do. The second would be start a blog. This is something we didn't really have in my day. I used what were called these computer bulletin boards, which were a very early way of communicating online. But now anyone can put up a blog, anyone can get a readership. The third advice I would give is get some editing experience.
Today's show will feature two experts discussing some of the highlights of the U.S. Supreme Court's 2012 session. Before the court went into recess at the end of June, it handed down several major decisions that will affect the lives of all Americans. Brian, can you tell us your take on the Roberts Court?
Sure, Carol. I think most scholars are of the view that despite a couple of the high-profile decisions from this past term, the Roberts Court is one of the most conservative Supreme Courts in American history. There's the Citizens United decision, which was a win for the First Amendment. There's a lot of opinions, frankly, that have been victories for the First Amendment.
James.
Well, it's funny that Brian characterizes cases expanding the First Amendment as conservative cases. For many years, that would be considered a liberal cause.
What we're going to do now is talk about two of the biggest cases before the court. The question before the court was whether or not Arizona as a state had the right to regulate immigration, or was that exclusively a responsibility of the federal government. The other case, known as Obamacare, the official name is Florida versus United States Department of Health Care. And this has to do with the individual mandate. Does the health insurance mandate violate the Constitution? Brian, James, what do you think about these cases?
Nobody really denies that Congress could, if it wanted, pass a law precluding Arizona from enacting these statutes.
The whole reason why states are passing these immigration laws is because there's a sense that the federal government is not doing its part to protect the citizens.
The decision leaves very little room for states to do much, to be honest with you. The one provision that was upheld allows the state law enforcement officers to ask for verification of citizenship, but what is the state officer going to do if the citizenship papers come back without any verification?
Now let's turn our attention to Obamacare.
I think that this case was a political defeat for conservatives, but I think it's going to be a legal victory.
Here we had some magnificent reasoning from Chief Justice Roberts on the Commerce Clause. Then he turns around and engages in some really bizarre statutory interpretation.
It's appalling to me how this administration, the Obama administration, misleads the public. And it's important for our conservative viewers to know that this law can be repealed. It's very important that you read the U.S. Constitution, know what the Constitution has to say, and we will have a link to that on our website. Support strong constitutionalist candidates. Fight for the control of the Senate and control of the executive branch, and remember to hold incumbents accountable. We the people have the power to be the people who will reclaim the values and principles that made our nation great. We can and will be the light of the world.